MedCram.
Welcome to another MedCram lecture. We're going to talk about emphysema today. Otherwise known as COPD. It seems as though these diseases have abbreviations in medicine. This one is chronic obstructive pulmonary disease. So what is COPD? It's a common, preventable, and treatable lung disease. And typical symptoms that you'll see in patients with emphysema or COPD is shortness of breath, and you'll also see cough, and if it's wet, then you'll have sputum as well. So these are very nonspecific symptoms, but they're very typical of what you see in COPD. So how important of a disease is this? A couple of statistics that you should know. It's the third most common cause of death in the U.S. Pretty significant. So there's a number two and there's a number one above it, and that's a heart disease and cancer. Heart disease and cancer. And sometimes these, depending on how you survey, will flip spots. There's also number four and number five. The key here is that this is the only cause of death in the United States out of these five that have actually gone up from about 2007 to 2010. All the others have gone down in frequency except for this one. So this is a pretty significant disease that we've got to be concerned about. In addition to all of this, it's also the second leading cause of disability. Okay, so the bottom line here is that this is a very important disease to know about. And in case, of course, if you're wondering how much this costs the U.S. healthcare system in the United States every year, the answer is about 50 B with a billion. Okay, 50 billion with a B. That's quite a lot of money. So as I mentioned, COPD, or emphysema, is a disease that affects the lungs. And specifically, if you were to take a look at your lungs, you of course know that your lungs have two sides and that there's a major airway called the trachea, and it branches off into the right and left main stem bronchus. And from there, it just goes down to smaller and smaller branches without getting into too much anatomy. Well, if we were to take these very small bronchioles or respiratory bronchioles, they would eventually end in a grape-like cluster called an alveolus. And this essentially increases the surface area. So this is what a normal respiratory bronchiole would look like. And if you were to take all of these alveoli in the entire lung and spread it out, it would be about the size of a tennis court. It's pretty big. And these bronchioles, of course, allow the air that you breathe in to go down and cause gas exchange. Now, COPD affects two main areas. It affects this bronchus, the small bronchial, and it also affects the alveolus in a bad way. What happens is because the elastic fibers are destroyed, and we'll get into that later, is that that airway becomes very collapsible, and essentially it becomes very small. And that's where the obstruction in COPD comes from. But furthermore, you're also going to get destruction of the alveoli, and you lose a lot of surface area. So instead of having a nice tennis court, you end up with maybe a badminton court or even a table tennis court here that you're working with. So the surface area becomes much smaller. And all these changes happen throughout the lung, but mostly in the upper regions of the lung. And as a result of that, it's hard to get the air out. There's an obstruction. And so that's the key point there, is that air cannot get out of the lungs. That's why it's called chronic obstructive pulmonary disease. But in addition to that, because these alveoli are all destroyed and become areas of large balloons, if you will, the lung actually increases in size. And as a result of that, you get these patients with large lungs but they're full of air and they can't get the air out. And that's basically COPD. So the way that we diagnose COPD is based on this obstruction. So we sit them down in front of a spirometer, and that's basically a machine where you breathe into it and it measures how much you breathe out. And we ask them to basically breathe out, after taking a deep breath in, breathe out as much air as they possibly can. And we measure it. So this is represents how much air they can blow out given enough time to blow it out. So we give them 6 to 10 seconds to blow it out, enough time that they need to blow everything they possibly can out in the lung. And we call that, by the way, the forced vital capacity, otherwise known as the FVC. So that's how much air they can blow out completely. But we said that COPD is an obstructive lung disease, and so what we're really looking for is how fast can they get that air out? Because if there's an obstruction, that's going to impede their ability to get that air out as fast as they possibly can. And so the next thing that we do is we have them do the same maneuver, but we measure how much comes out in 1 second. So there's kind of a timed proportion to this. How much can you blow out given an infinite amount of time? And how much can you blow out in just 1 second? So there's a little bit of a velocity factor involved there. And so what we do is, we call that, by the way, the forced expiratory volume in 1 second. This is otherwise known as the FEV1. Okay, so then we do a very simple calculation. We measure and we see, we take this number, the forced expiratory volume, and we divide it by the forced vital capacity number, and we come up with a fraction. This is known as the FEV1 divided by the FVC ratio. Okay? And the definition that's come up in the literature is that 0.70 is the cutoff. If the FEV1 divided by the FVC ratio is less than 0.70, that means that you could get less than 70% of the air that you could normally get out, given an infinite amount of time, out in the first second. That means you've got obstructive lung disease. If you can get more than 0.7 out, that means you don't have obstructive lung disease. So the question here is, can you get out at least 70% of the air that you could normally blow out in the first second? And if the answer is yes, then you don't have obstructive lung disease. If the answer is no, and it's less than 0.7, then you have obstructive lung disease. And of course, the lower this number is, the FEV1, the worse your COPD is going to be. Okay, so let's review. COPD is one, common. It costs a lot. Number two, it's the third leading cause of death, and it's the only one of the five that are actually increasing in frequency. Number three, causes difficulty with breathing out, that's obstruction. Number four, reduces the cross-sectional surface area, causes drops in oxygen. You diagnose it by spirometry. And then finally, number six, the diagnosis is the FEV1 divided by the FVC is less than 0.7. Thank you for joining us.